Hi, this is Robert Bornstein from Robert's Tropical Paradise Garden, and this morning we're going to check for rare tropical fruit we can pick in the garden. Now the mango is already done, and now it's the sugar apple's turn, or sweet sop. It's in the Annonaceae family. It's a rare and exotic fruit that grows really well in South Florida, Central America, and Asia. So I may need this picker. Luckily the tree only gets about 20 feet. Or I may need my pruners. So we're gonna now get the fruit before the critters get it. Now let's go into the garden and see what we can find. Here's the tree. And at the tips are the fruit. Now here's one up here, but it's not ready yet. This one over here is already eaten. One of the critters already ate it. Now if we go over to this area, over here, these are perfect for picking. See these two? Now you want to pick it when it's a little yellow towards the inside. Then it's ready. Same thing with here. If you wait too long, it splits open and the bugs and the birds and the rats eat it. So we have to pick it before they get to it. Now how we're going to pick it, we're just going to, it's a big thick stem. We just use our snips like this and cut it off. Same thing with over here. See, this one's very green, so I'm going to leave it on the tree because it's not ready yet. We have to wait. You should eat no fruit before it's time. Okay, now if we go all the way to the top of the tree, I see one really, really nice right there. So we're going to try to get it with a fruit picker. Okay, now I'm going to try to navigate all the branches and the unripe fruits to reach the ripe one, all the way up top. It's a little tricky. When you make one try, then you make another try, and eventually you succeed. Just takes a little time. There's a lot of branches. There we go. Now we pull it down. Oops, missed it. Gonna try again. These are thick stems, so they're not easy to grab. There we have it. Oh, shoot. Up. Guess what happened? The picker fell off from the pole. Well, we had no luck finding the basket, so we're going to head up on the ladder and get the fruit this way. See what we can get from this height. Oh, there's a beauty. I'm going to move the ladder. Hey, look at this. Here's the basket we were looking for. So we're going to reattach that as well. But first, let me get this fruit with the ladder. Hopefully, I can get close enough. You want to have the ladder as steady as possible, of course. Has to have steady ground. Here's a palm I put in. It's good to hold on to. There it is. I'm going to pull this branch down. And I am going to... Wow, that's on tight. I'm going to cut it with my pruners. I don't want it to fall, though. There. Look at this big one. Isn't that great? Can you see it? Nice. Okay, let's see what else we can get. So it's been about a week. We let the fruit ripen inside, and as you see, it's ripened to a darker color. And what we're going to do now is, like the cherimoya in the previous video, You just grab it like this and then open it up. And as you can see, the fruit has a lot of seeds in there. So this is how we eat it now. Now you can just eat it like this, and or you can eat it with a spoon. And each one of those little black dots is a seed. So when you put it in your mouth, you have to eat around the seed. I didn't want to talk with food in my mouth. So as you can see here, these are the seeds. Now what's wonderful about the sugar apple is the seeds do come true to the mother plant in my variety, so I can plant these and grow more sugar apples. Now once the seeds are dried, you can use this for craft projects. Put these in a yogurt cup with the lid and you have a little maraca. But the fruit is smooth, extremely sweet, and very delicious. People on the island get a whole bunch of these and then make a milkshake with it. You can even add rum. So I'm glad you got to see my sugar apple fruit, see how we pick it, and see how we eat it. So thanks again for coming to Robert's Tropical Paradise Garden. Please follow my writing. I'm the Miami Garden Reporter for Examiner.com. Look at my website, www.robbornstein.com. Look at all my other videos. I have about 34 of them now. This channel is getting really, really popular. I'm very happy for your support. And I want you to look at my Facebook page, Robert's Tropical Paradise Garden. There's always great stuff on there, and we have an international following. Also, the blog of my same name has a lot of personal, wonderful stories. Robert's Tropical Paradise Garden. So see you again soon, and thanks for stopping by.